All right. In this one, I would like to do an in-depth tutorial of the printf function, which is a function you probably use since your very beginning in the C programming language, but it's actually one of the most complex functions that there is in the standard library, in my opinion. And so yeah, I would like to show all its intricacies to you. So yeah, you can see that you know the basic usage of the printf. You just have percentage d for an integer, for example, and yeah, it prints it. But there is a lot more of what are called conversions. So the letter here is called the percentage, then percentage, then the letter is called a conversion. So there is u for unsigned integer. So if you print minus 32, it does weird stuff. It's only for unsigned. Then there is f for floats, for doubles actually. It converts floats to double. So those you probably are very familiar with. I'm going to run through them quickly. There is a percentage p, which is actually for a pointer. So if you do a1, it will print and you give the address of a. It will give so you see the float, and it prints the address of that variable. Then there is c for a character. So for example, a. There is you probably know this one, a for a string. Hello. So far nothing too difficult. Then one you might not know is if you want to actually print just a percentage, you just do percentage, and that prints a percentage. Very useful stuff. Then there is G. Wait, I think it's first E. Those are for floats, but it's in the scientific notation. So if you do I don't know, a big number, a big floating point number, you can see up you see that it will use the scientific notation for it. And there is a G, which will pick according to the size of the number if it's E or F, I think. So here in this case, it picks this. But if I put a simple one, yeah, it picks F. So if it's a large number or a long number, it will pick the scientific notation. If it's a smaller number or simpler to represent number, it will do the regular floating point notation. And those are all the conversions that you will probably need. Next, you can change the width of the thing that is printed. So for example, let's say I put some extra characters here at the beginning and at the end. So we still have our minus 32. Let me put that on top. And now if you put between the percentage and the D a number, so let's say 5, it will make sure that the number of characters it prints at this place is always 5. And if the number is greater than 5 characters, it will just ignore the width and print all of them. Next, there is also a modifier for this. So if you put 0 in it will do the padding of the number, but with zeros instead of spaces. So you can see here that it did 32 and then 0, 0. You can also put space here. Let's put just space and 5. What this will do is this will actually, let's just do percentage space d. This will leave one space for the sign. So if it's a minus, you don't see the difference, but if it's a positive integer, it will leave a space for the plus symbol. This is very useful if you want to align integers. So if you have a bunch of integers, both negative and positive, that you want to align, you do this option so that you have the minus sign when it's minus and just a space so that the numbers are neatly next to each other. You can also have the plus instead, which will always print the sign. Whether so if it's a plus, prints a plus, if it's a negative number, prints a minus. Again, very neat to align stuff. Then you have for the still the width, so if you want this, let's say I want 10 space, 10 character of width, I can do minus 10 to, so that it will align it, but on the other side, so on the left. As you see, we have minus 32 and then a bunch of empty spaces. Next. For floating point numbers, you see that, I mean, it will be even more flagrant if I put a large number of decimal places after this. So you can see that it prints by default, I think, 6 of precision. So even if my number was 42.42, it still prints a bunch of zeros. And here, if you have a very large floating point number, it often happens in... I don't know, when you're doing 3D graphics and you're printing something that you have a humongous a number of decimal places and you want to trim that because you really don't care that much when you print, you can do dot and then the number of precision. So let's do dot two and it will round your number to the second decimal place. Precision, prefix, yeah. Reading my notes because there is a lot of information. A thing that you can do that is sometimes useful if the width or the precision you want for the width for anything and the precision for floating point numbers is variable. So if you don't know in advance that it's going to be 5 of width and you need to know that at runtime, you have the option of putting a star here. And what this will do is that it will take the width from the argument just before the actual number. So if I say 10 here, it will take the width from this argument and the number from this one. Up, as you can see, I still have 10 of width, but if I put 5 here, it did 5 of width. And you can also do this for floating points. So if you have a star dot star, it will take the width from this from the first argument, the precision from the second one, and the actual value from the third one. So if I do 5.2, yeah, and I do more than 5 for this one, it took the width from the first one, precision you can see is 2, and the number is the number. Next, there is one that I've used not that often, which is to print in a more to split the thousands with a human in a human readable form. Let's remove all this. And you just put a single quote between the percentage and whatever your conversion is. And it should, actually it doesn't do it for me, but it says that, so you see, you can look all that in man printf, that the, do we have the single quote, where is the single quote, I don't remember, I think it's explained here, but like, according to your local, so, I guess my local is, it should be US, so it's strange that it doesn't do it, but maybe if you're like in France or something, it will split the thousands with a dot or a comma or whatever your local is. Yeah, like this. So it's with a DADK, which I don't have. Next, we have... that I've already explained. We have the length modifier. So yeah, if you have a long int instead of let's call it L, I don't know, some long value. That's not even a long value, but whatever. And let's say I have a L here. And actually, let's make it really long to showcase what I mean. Is that good? Is that good? Le terrain est tout large. Tout large. That was. Oh. Ok. So, as you can see, since we told printf that this was an integer and not an long integer, it overflowed and it gave us a negative number. But if you put the LD instead, before or the L before the D, it will interpret it correctly, like so. And same thing with a long int, you have to put LLD, like so. And if you want instead interpret a short S of this, you can print a short with, I think, HD. Like this, and so this is a short, like so. And if you want to interpret like a char, but in like a decimal format, so I guess char c is equal to something, this will interpret a character as a decimal, so a single byte integer. And you have a bunch of those, but those are the most useful one. There is also one that is useful because when you use often size t, I think it's in std def that this is defined. So size, and size t is like an unsigned integer that can be either 64, 30, 32. It's like a platform independent unsigned thing when you want just to get give the size of something. And for this specific type, the modifier is ZU, so size. So if you want to interpret size T, it's always Z before the actual conversion character. Up, like so. And you can go into the printf man, I think at the very end. It explains, yeah, so here in this section, I think, no, in this section, you see it explains like what HHE is, LL, then there is a bunch of other ones, weird ones, you can see Z here, there is like J even, I never use those, but basically there is a bunch of them to interpret as different types, as the arguments. And yes, that's it. That's mainly those are the most useful ones that at least I use for the formatting string in itself. But you also have again, I'm gonna open the man page. You can see that there is a lot of variation of printf, but they're actually rather simple. So let's go through them. So printf regular printf. Then there you have fprintf to print to a file, and so let's quickly do this. File f is equal to open foo in read write mode, and what we're gonna do is fprintf, and then you give it the file handle, and then let's see, let's say I want to print two numbers in there, and I want to print and 2, like so, and f close f. Of course, no error checking because I'm speedrunning. Apparently, that did not work. I'm not sure why. I'm actually not sure why. Can I do this in. Okay, so my. I haven't used fopen in a long time, apparently. but yeah, okay. If I open it in write mode only, and I cat foo, You can see put the output of printf in it. Next one, we have dprintf. This is the exact same thing, but with a file descriptor instead of a file stream, that they call it. So it's if you use the open file descriptor, the open syscall like this, and you get an FD, and it's basically the exact same thing. Next is sprintf that you should never use. I mean, you can use it for debugging or if you trust your code, but if you're gonna export this to like actual user, you're gonna run into buffer overflow issues because it doesn't check the actual length of the string. So it's to because I didn't explain what it does. It's to output it's to output the output of printf into a string or a character buffer. Let's quickly do this. Character buffer, cool buff, and it's 256, let's say. Let's initialize it with 0 and then s printf, and I want to specify the buffer, and then let's say I want to do d again, just the exact same thing, with 3.2 again, and then why not use printf, printf again, and I want to print the string that I just generated that is in buff. And as you can see, it put in this character buffer, it put the string that it put the string 3 and 2. The string 3.2. But the reason this is bad is because so for numbers it's okay, but let's say you have a buffer that is of size 10 and you have a string here, and let's say that this string actually is the user is able to modify it, so the user could type anything he wants in it. This would overflow the buffer and actually overflow the next value on the stack, which could be critical to your application. So yeah, actually stack smashing detected, so you already have problems, but yeah. And that's why you use sprintf, which is the exact same thing, but here you specify the size of the buffer. And if you do that, you won't have any trouble. It will actually stop the printf before it overflows. And that's pretty much it for the variant of printf. And as you can see, there is every time a V variant as well. And those are, instead of the three dots, instead of you making the, no, instead of printf making the variable argument list, you give it yourself the argument pointer. And this is very useful when you want to wrap the printf behavior. So I think I have this example, not sure, let's say sed. Do I have day? Yes, I think I have it here. So as you can see, I made my own function to like cleanly, not if there is an error, I want to exit my application. And here my function has a format and the variable list. And so I build the argument pointer, the variable argument list myself, and I actually want printf to reuse that, not have the three dots. So you can see if I go into vputError, this actually calls vfprintf, like so. And that's one of the, that's the only case where I found I wanted to use the v variants of printf. And yeah, I think that's finally it for the in-depth printf tool. I think I rushed it a bit, but this still took 20 minutes. So yeah, hopefully you got something out of that. And again, don't hesitate to read a bit the manual of printf, which is very interesting. And yeah, printing becomes very easy once you know all that. Yeah, so anyway, hope you liked it, and see you.